In this video, I'll show you how to use GroupBox to create a card-like design that you see here with this now playing card. But it's pretty versatile. You can use GroupBox for things like this end user license agreement or even a chart. It's essentially a built-in card view in SwiftUI. Let me show you how to use it so you can get this look and feel for your app. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. Okay, so here in Xcode, this is just a brand new app. You see the Hello World sample code. I haven't written a line of code yet. So in our V stack, instead of the image, let's type group box. And you can see we get a couple initializers, configuration, content, title key, content, and label. So if you just do content, we'll start with this text. This is my group box. Isn't it cool? It's like a card view. Awesome. So just by wrapping it in a group box, you see we get the light gray background with the rounded corners and it looks like a card. So that is the most bare bones basic use of group box. But we can add the text here for a label, say my content. And you can see my content is bolded. Now, you'll notice it might be off a little bit, right? It's not completely aligned left because if I delete some of this text, you'll see the text portion of this is centered by default. Now we can customize that later by creating a custom modifier. We'll get into that at the end of the video. So do a command Z to get my text back. And just like any other Swift UI view, you can, you know, adjust the frame if you don't want it to be full screen like that. So we'll do a width of, you know, 240. There you go. Get a nice little card for your content there. So again, that's the absolute basics. Let's start sprucing this up a little bit, adding some SF symbols to the label and adding a more detailed view into our group box. So I'll keep that group box there. We'll add another one in the V stack below it. So we'll say group box. And now we want the content and label. So title key and content is what we have up there on line 13 with the string and then the content. So with the content and label, now look, label and content was deprecated, but if I click content and label, it still gives me label and content. This is like a bug in Xcode. So I'm gonna type this out manually. So we'll use the trailing closure syntax, just do group box and then do a label parameter down here with an open closure. So here in the content, we'll just bring in our text from up here for now. Again, we're gonna spruce that up a little bit. So our content goes in the first closure and then our label, which we will actually make a label with a title key and system image. So system image gives us the SF symbol. So title key will be now playing. And then the SF symbol that I just have memorized is music.note. There you go, that gives us the music note that you see there. Let's add some spacing to our V stack up here so it's not so crammed there. So you can see, even just adding a simple SF symbol already makes the group box look a lot nicer. Now, I'm about to do something I know all of you hate in tutorials. I'm going to paste in a lot of UI code. And the reason I'm doing that is because this music player that I'm pasting in here, this view, is just super basic Swift UI. The H stack with the rounded rectangle, you know, V stack of text, progress view, H stack. I'm cutting off 5 minutes off the video so I don't have to type all this. Because this is the music player that we're going to put in here. Instead of this text here of this is my group box, I'll put in music player view. And the reason I did that is to show you that you can build pretty much whatever UI you want into this group box. Like I said, here's the example of the end user license agreement with a little switch at the bottom. Here's an example of throwing a chart into a group box. And again, this music player view, as you can see now, very, very basic Swift UI. So I've just saved us all some time there. But let's tweak this a little bit because as you're probably starting to notice, this group box view in Swift UI just essentially gives us the background card view with the rounded corners and the option to put this label at the top. Because in this content is just a V stack of whatever views you want to put in there. But when you nest your group boxes, it automatically differentiates the colors of each group box, which I think is a nice touch. So we'll put this music player in another group box. This time we're just going to do content because we don't want to put, you know, a label or anything on it. We just want to differentiate it visually into a different group box. Now you see here, we get the two boxes, which I think is a pretty cool look if you're going for it. And dark mode is where this, you know, really shines. So running the app here on dark mode, you can see you get this cool now playing. And then because it's a nested group box, you automatically get that nested box. So again, this built-in card view in Swift UI is really nice. And we can do some basic customization right here in this group box. So this label, I can say .foreground style.pink, and you can see it in the preview. Our label is now pink. And again, if I run it on dark mode, I think that looks really cool. There it is. Kind of looks like the music app, right? Get that now playing. And this is styling an individual group box. So what we're going to do now is create a custom modifier where we can change the background of the group box, make it more of a material background. You know, if we're building a bunch of group boxes in our app, we can have this one modifier that is a common theme amongst all of them. That way we're not customizing each individual one. So let's go ahead and create that modifier. We'll do it above the music player view here. And it's a struct music group box style. And that is of type group box style that you see here. Okay, we need a function called make body. This is required for a custom style. So the configuration that we get here is the configuration.label and configuration.content. So within group box, that's what you get. Back up here, we have our group box with our content, which is another group box in a music player, and then our label. So now that we have access to our label and our content, we can customize accordingly. And actually, I'm going to throw this into a VStack because remember, like I said, I want to override the existing VStack in here in the style because it automatically centers things. And in the example of our just our basic content box, I want to make sure everything is aligned left. So we'll add the alignment parameter and that'll be dot leading. And since we're making this music group box style, kind of the style for our app, we'll go ahead and do foreground style on the label of dot pink. So again, this will make every label in our group box style that we mark with music style, you know, whatever style we're creating right here. And of course you could create multiple styles if you wanted different ones throughout your app. Now, before we customize this any further, let's go ahead and put it onto our group boxes. So as I'm making further customizations, we can see it in real time on our preview. That'll really illustrate the point here. And this is an extension on group box style, but we want to say where self is equal to music group box style. And it's a static var music of type music group box style. That's what we just created up here. And we'll initialize a new one. So with this little bit of code here, it gives us, again, the syntactic sugar that up here on our group box, or overall group box here, we can do dot group box style. Now there's automatic, which is what we get, and then there's the music one that we just created. Now you're not gonna see that because our now playing is already pink, but let's get rid of our foreground style pink, and you should see no change. But if we comment out our modifier, now you see now playing went back to black text, whereas when we have our modifier on there, it is now red text, but aha. Here's the tricky thing. When you're overriding the styles here, like we're doing here, we're overriding all the styles. So we have to re-implement the background, the corner radius, making our label bold, all that stuff. Because again, we're overriding the existing style. But this gives you full freedom to change the background color of your group boxes, which we're actually gonna use a material because that's a pretty common background for this card style. But let me go up to our basic group box and add dot group box style of dot music. So now we can see both of our group boxes update in real time as we're adjusting our custom style. But you can see up there, the style also went away as well. So on the VStack, we want some padding and we'll do dot background style in. So the style we want is just regular material. Again, materials are how you can kind of see through and the background will bleed through. And then the shape is rounded rectangle with a corner radius, we'll say 12 here. But again, you're customizing your cards. If you want to make a larger corner radius, say 20, there you go. You get that look and feel that you see. So we'll say 12. And then now we need to customize our label. So we just want it to be dot bold. Now you see our label is bold. But here again, if you wanted to do font design dot monospaced, if you wanted a different font type, there you go. Now it looks like that. Again, we're customizing everything we mark with a custom group box style here. Let's get rid of that monospace and just go back to bold. And then so we can see the material background, let's throw this V stack into a Z stack and add a rectangle with a foreground style dot pink dot gradient dot opacity of 0.8. And then we will ignore the safe area. And that's because I have my padding on the Z stack and not the V stack that got switched up when I copy and pasted. But now you can see our background. Let me actually run it so we can switch between light and dark mode. But we can see our background is now that material. So the background color is bleeding through. That is in dark mode. And that is in light mode, but you notice the inner box is still solid. That's because we haven't applied our group box style to our inner box here. So dot group box style of dot music and refresh the preview and you'll be able to see it there. It is a subtle difference, but you can see the background bleed through and then we'll run it to see it on light and dark mode. And there you go. Even the inner group box is now starting to bleed through a little bit. Command shift A to go to light mode and that's a much nicer look. So group boxes are a great way to create this card-like UI all throughout your app. And again, if you want to go the extra mile to customize every little bit of it so you have a theme on all your cards throughout your app, using this custom modifier down here is how you do that. And again, you can customize it however you like. If you're learning about group boxes to improve the UI of your app, you're probably building a great one and you're going to need a portfolio website to showcase your work. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're developers, we can build a website ourselves, but we're also iOS developers, and I would argue there's an opportunity cost of your time. Now, do you want to spend your time learning about web development, responsive design, all the different browsers, or do you want to spend your time building apps? So that's why I always recommend letting Squarespace take that off your plate to build your iOS developer portfolio. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started, and you can use their next generation website editor with the Fluid Engine to just really unlock all the creativity in the world. You can even use Squarespace Blueprint and Squarespace AI to help you figure out what to write on your website, because that's always the hardest part. Like, I don't even know what to say here. Throw it into Squarespace's AI and they'll help you out. They handle all the SEO and analytics for you. Again, Squarespace, handling your website just takes so much off your plate. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.